All right, let me now give you the brief picture overview of the loss function of the variational autoencoder. So overall, it's about minimizing elbow, the evidence lower bound. So if you have not heard about elbow or the evidence lower bound before, don't worry about it too much for this class. So for here, it's not really that important. That would be something for a follow-up class, or maybe you would encounter this in a class on variational Bayesian methods or something like that. So for here, maybe it's not that important, but overall we are optimizing or minimizing a loss that consists of minimizing the expected negative likelihood of the data, and then the Kolbeck-Leibler divergence term, which is the difference essentially between this latent space distribution and a standard multivariate Gaussian distribution. So technically you would be maximizing the log likelihood of the data, but as we discussed before when we talked about logistic regression a long time ago, maximizing the log likelihood is the same as minimizing the negative log likelihood. So that's why I've written it like this with this negative sign here. But again, the details are not that important. Like, if you have not encountered this before, don't worry about it too much. The big picture is that this is a reconstruction loss term. It's essentially the reconstruction between, or the difference between, input and output distribution here. And the KL divergence is making sure that this one here is essentially a standard multivariate Gaussian distribution. Now, if you would look at some implementations of variational autoencoders, what you might find is that usually for the reconstructionists, people either use the binary cross entropy or the mean squared error. Both work in practice. Personally, I would say it makes more sense to use the mean squared error, because so people use the BCE when they normalize the images to 0-1 range, and they also have the 0-1 range here, the pixels. Originally, image pixels are between 0 and 255, and you can normalize them in 0-1 range. And in fact, this is done automatically in PyTorch when we call the toTensor method in the data transform. So you will see that in the code example. And then you can have here sigmoid activation, logistic sigmoid, and then you will also automatically ensure that the outputs are in a 0-1 range. And it might be tempting then to use a binary cross entropy, but keep in mind this is not a Bernoulli distribution. I mean, this is not 0 or 1, the value of the pixel, it's between 0 and 1. And frankly, I don't know why some people would use BCE for that. I would use a BCE if that would be a multivariate Bernoulli distribution, if I have values like zeros and ones for the input, but we have values between 0 and 1, so to me it makes more sense to use the MSE. And also in practice, when you do some comparisons, you will find probably, so it's at least what I found, that if you use the BCE, the images would look a little bit blurrier. Could be because it's kind of forcing the pixels to be more in the center of the distribution. In any case, so yeah, what I also want to show you, let me go to the next part maybe. I wanted to show you that the cross entropy is not symmetric. So this is also one issue why I think it's probably not a good idea to use a binary cross entropy as a reconstruction loss, because the loss is different depending on the pixel values. What I mean by that, if what I'm showing you on the left-hand side is a plot where I plotted the binary cross entropy loss for values of the true and the predicted label. So here, zero is probably a bad example, but let's say 0.2. Here what I mean is, when we consider the cross entropy, that the true value is 0.2. And the predicted value is 0.2, so that's how we compute. It should be minus cross entropy. Oh yeah, for reference, I have it also here. So recall the binary cross entropy from the logistic regression class. We have a probability here, the log, the probability here. Usually in the logistic regression context, this was either a 1 or a 0. Now we have values between 0 and 1. So if I have a pixel in my input image of 0.2, and I predict a pixel of 0.2, I would get a loss. It's around 0.5 here. Now here, what I have is I have an input pixel of 0.4 and a predicted pixel value of 0.4 as well. What I can see is the loss is higher. It's around, I don't know, 6.5, something like that. So you can see, even though I reconstruct the right pixel, 0.4 is the reconstruction and 0.4 is the original label, I get a higher loss now compared as if it was 0.2. So it's not symmetric. I get different losses depending on what my pixel values are, which doesn't really make sense. So if you have a mean squared error loss here, if this is, let's say, my 0 here, we would have 0 everywhere, because the MSE, there's no difference between the 0.4 and the 0.4, so the MSE would be 0.4 minus 0.4 squared, which would be 0. That makes more sense to me, at least. Well, here's another example. Consider we have the true pixel value 0.8 and the reconstructed pixel value is 0.7. So we are off by 0.1. We would get a loss of 0.28. If I have now 0.9 years for a reconstruction, still I'm off by only 0.1. Now I get a 0.08, right? So for some reason, it penalizes this 0.7 more than this 0.9, because it's not symmetric. Same as if I have a minus 0.2 here as the true pixel, and I put it 0.1 here, 0.3, we'll find these are different values. Yeah, this is why I would suggest for the variational autoencoder to, if you have input pixels between 0 and 1, or between minus 1 and 1, doesn't matter. If you have input pixels on a continuous range, I would suggest using the MSE instead of the binary cross entropy for the reconstruction term. All right, so this was now the first term. So if I go back one more slide, so this was the first term that we discussed, the reconstruction loss. So I suggest using the mean squared error for that. So the mean here is over the examples in the batch. For if you only have one training example, you can think of it as the sum squared error between all the pixels. So it's essentially a Euclidean distance. So you would, for each pair of pixels, compare the difference, square it, and then you sum them all up and you take the square root. So you have the original dimension back, and then you can average that over the batch, and that would be then your mean squared error. And I will show you, of course, in the code example how that looks like. I think that will also make things more clear. The second term is the KL divergence term. So this is measuring the difference between the distribution here and the latent space, this part. So we have our mean vector and our log var vector. So I'm only showing it as one vector, but there should be technically two vectors, the mean vector and the log var vector. Here I'm just writing it as a standard deviation. So we are minimizing the difference between this distribution of the latent space and a standard normal distribution. So we use the KL divergence term for that. And it can be written as follows, as shown here. I'm not showing you here the derivation, I'm just showing you how you can write that. I have two slides later, I have the derivation here, but I don't want to go into or through this in detail. If you're interested, I actually got this from this link here. I was not writing this myself, but if you're interested in studying this, you can find it here. It's how you derive the KL loss for the variational autoencoder. going back to this one here, what's more interesting is to take a quick look at this. So you can see we have this one plus here, plus this log var. This is our from the log var trick. And yeah, you can see this would be minimized if we have 1 minus the variance 1, if we have a variance of 1. So we would minimize this if the variance is actually 1. So log of 1 should be also 0 then, right? And if this is 0. So if we have 1 plus 0 minus 0 minus 1 gives us 0. This is when our KL divergence term is minimized. So what we want here is this mean vector to be close to 0 and the variance to be close to 0, close to 1, which happens if this log var term is close to 0. So that's essentially what the KL divergence term forces this and this vector to be. And then if this is true, I mean, if our mean vector is 0 and our variance vector is 1, so if this is 1 and this is 0, then what we have is that as our distribution will be standard normal distribution. That is our goal for this latent representation. All right, so this is essentially, in a nutshell, the variational autoencoder loss function. Again, if you're interested, you can take a look at the loss derivation. And now in the next video, I will finally show you how this all comes together in a code example, where we have the sampling aspect, the log var trick, and the loss function, everything together in one code example, where I will show you that we can train this autoencoder to generate handwritten digits. But since handwritten digits are by now, I think, a little bit boring, we will also use a second data set and apply this concept to face images.